Have you ever eaten a homegrown cantaloupe right off the vine? If you have, you know why we grow cantaloupe. Nothing in the store can compare to the sweet taste that you get from growing your own cantaloupe in your garden. In today's video, I'm going to share all my best cantaloupe growing tips. Cantaloupe thrives in warm weather and needs a long growing season, which is great news for us desert growers. Let's talk about where to plant your cantaloupe. Number one, cantaloupe needs sun to grow well. Cantaloupe that doesn't get enough sun is going to be less vigorous and more sickly than cantaloupe that gets plenty of sun. Give it afternoon shade, that's great actually. Everything in the desert benefits from a little afternoon shade, but make sure it gets plenty of sun. And that sun is going to produce vigorous vines, which will in turn make delicious cantaloupe. Cantaloupe does best when grown in fertile, rich soil full of organic matter. Amend your planting area with lots of compost before planting cantaloupe. Most cantaloupe varieties do really well when planted here in the low desert. If you've had issues with things like powdery mildew in the past, look for disease-resistant varieties like Ambrosia or Planter's Jumbo. Those varieties are both more powdery mildew resistant. You can also look for short season varieties, smaller types of cantaloupes, the mini cantaloupes. Those perform really well here as well. You're going to get a lot of smaller fruit that ripen over a period of time. Don't be in too big of a hurry to plant cantaloupe. Cantaloupe does best in warm weather. Here in the low desert, plant cantaloupe after the last frost all the way through about July in the low desert. It's one of those few things that we can plant during the month of July, which is great. So you may have enough time to get a few different crops of cantaloupe growing throughout the growing season. If you live in cooler areas with shorter growing seasons, start seeds for cantaloupe indoors about 3 weeks before your last frost date, and make sure to wait until all danger of frost has passed before you plant that cantaloupe out. Cantaloupe is very frost sensitive and will not be happy if it gets frozen. It's happiest if you can start it out right in place in the garden, planting it from seed. If you do buy transplants or start indoors from seed, plant as young a seedling as you can and be very careful not to disturb those roots, and you'll have a lot better success when you're using transplants when planting cantaloupe. When you plant cantaloupe seeds, plant two or three in each hole, and then when those seedlings are 2 to 3 inches tall and are developing their first leaves, thin it out to just one seedling. Look for the happiest, healthiest seedling, and then just snip the other two, and then that one happy, healthy seedling is going to grow and develop and have more chance of success than if you leave all three of those. You want to make sure you give enough room for each plant to grow well. Rotate where you plant cantaloupe every year. Think about where you've planted things like cucumbers and squash and pumpkins, and choose a different spot to plant cantaloupe in. Those vegetables and fruits are all in the same family. If you continually grow them in the same spot each year, pests and diseases that like those crops are going to build up in your soil. Cantaloupe vines get large and they need plenty of room to grow. They don't grow quite as large as watermelon vines do, but you still need plenty of room to grow them. My favorite way to grow cantaloupes is vertically. They love to climb. The fruits are just heavy enough that they can kind of support themselves when they're growing. I have it growing over arbors and arches, ladder mesh block. I've grown cantaloupe on ladders. If it climbs, I've probably grown cantaloupe on it. It is a great crop to grow vertically. Cantaloupe can also just be grown in beds. Make sure you give it plenty of room, 3 to 4 feet between plants. And when it is growing in the ground or on the ground, be sure to keep a close eye on pests and diseases. They're a little harder to spot. Lift up those leaves, look for different bugs. Once the fruits form, be sure and put some kind of a melon cradle, a support underneath, because you hate to see this beautiful cantaloupe on top and then you turn it upside down. The underneath has just been eaten away by bugs. Let's talk about watering. Cantaloupe needs regular water to grow well. You want to water in the morning and not get water on the leaves, which is another reason why growing cantaloupe vertically is so great. Because if you can keep those leaves dry, you're less likely to spread diseases like powdery mildew. I water mine in raised beds during the hottest months of the year every morning. So make sure you're watering each time deep enough to penetrate the entire root zone. Once your seedlings are several inches high, it's also a good idea to add a thick layer of mulch, and that will help keep any weeds down and preserve that moisture and make for a much happier cantaloupe plant. Hopefully you've got lots of bees buzzing around your garden and they're happily pollinating everything. If you're having a problem with fruits withering and not getting pollinated, then make sure that you know the difference between a female cantaloupe flower and a male cantaloupe flower. And you may need to do some hand pollinating. Just transfer the pollen from the male flower to the female flower when they're both in bloom. And just like most plants, those male flowers are going to show up first, probably a week or two before, so just be patient. Here are a few of my favorite tips for growing the sweetest cantaloupe that is full of flavor. Don't prune off leaves or shoots. The leaves produce the sugars which sweeten all of the fruits. About a week before the melons are ripe, if you can, cut back on watering as much as possible to concentrate the fruit's sugars. Once picked, cantaloupe will continue to soften indoors, but it's not going to get any sweeter. So you really want to leave that cantaloupe on the vine as long as possible to get to that kind of sweet spot where it's so sweet and just the right texture. It's pretty easy to tell when to harvest cantaloupe. You're just going to use your senses. Look at the cantaloupe. It should change from kind of a green tint to more of a gold or an orangish hue. Once it does that, you know it's about ready. And then smell. Can you smell the cantaloupe? That's another clue that that cantaloupe is just about ready. Finally, that cantaloupe should slip easily off the vine. If you're growing it vertically, it may actually fall off the vine before you harvest it. That's a sure sign that that cantaloupe is ready to harvest. If you have to tug a little bit on the stem to get it to come off, it's not quite ready and you should have waited maybe one extra day. So as you watch your cantaloupes and see that they're getting close to harvest, pay attention to them, make sure you're looking at them every day because you don't want them to get overripe and mushy either. Watch for the signs that the cantaloupe is ready to harvest for best taste. All right, hopefully today you learned something about growing cantaloupe. If you have more questions, ask them in the comments below. I'll hop on and answer questions. Head to my blog, Growing in the Garden, where there's an article all about how to grow cantaloupe. Thank you so much for watching.